Hello, dear students. Здравствуйте, студенты. My name is Вероника. Меня зовут Вероника. And I am a professional Russian teacher. And of course, I am a Russian native speaker based in Moscow. And today, watching this mini Russian lesson, you will learn two important things. First of all, you will be able to boost your Russian vocabulary because I will explain you lots of different new Russian words related to houses. And the second very important thing, I will explain some interesting facts about Russian houses. So let's start. You have English translation on the screen. So I will be reading the Russian word two times, slowly as a Russian teacher and fast as a Russian native speaker, and some short explanation in English. So the first one, dom, dom, house. This kind of house you can find in Russian village or at Russian dacha. That is a very big and important Russian cultural concept. Next one is Russian skyscraper. Сталинская высотка. Сталинская высотка. It's extremely beautiful building, but quite unique because we have only 7 buildings like this in Moscow, and we call them семь сестер, 7 sisters. The style is сталинский ампир, and it is deeply connected with the name Stalin. I'm pretty sure you know him, right? So, сталинская высотка. When you see this in real life, you are very impressed because the building is so beautiful. And I studied it at Lomonosov Moscow State University, МГУ имени Ломоносова. It's one of the best universities in Russia, and the main building is exactly like this, one of Сталинская высотка. Next one is Хрущевка. Now some Хрущевкас are demolished, and they start to be demolished more and more because they are quite old and, let's say, ugly. But Хрущевка, guess to what person this word can be related. If you are interested in Russian history or Russian culture, most probably you know this person, Никита Хрущев. At his time, this type of building was super popular because he wanted to put many people in one place together. So they started to build Хрущевка more and more and more. But I have to say that this building is so uncomfortable. I mean, inconvenient. There is not a lot of space to live there. It's tiny space, you know, tiny kitchen where you can move only a little bit, and very tiny toilet. I never lived at Хрущевка, thanks God, but I have a friend who lives in Хрущевка, and when I came there, I was very sad after it because it's a very small place, you know. Another angle of Хрущевка. In Moscow, in any city of Russia, you can find millions of this Хрущевка. And now let's talk a little bit about Russian mythology and Slavic legends. We have this very interesting house. It's in the middle of the dense forest, and it is called Izbush. На курьих ножках. Избушка на курьих ножках. It can be literally translated hat on chicken legs. You see, here is a hat and here is chicken legs. And there lives very smart, but very tricky and unpleasant and ugly woman, witch. Let's say witch. Her name is Baba Yaga. Do you know something about her? If yes, please let me know in comments. Just interesting for me. And this избушка на курьих ножках. It can walk, it can run, it can turn around, you know, like this. It can just kind of dance. You can see this house dancing with balalaika in some Russian or Soviet cartoons. And this is how typical Soviet apartment looked like. Here you have ковер, carpet. There is important thing because carpet in Soviet Union was on the floor and also on the wall. Why? Why should you put a carpet, ковер, on the wall? There are two important functions. First of all, it was less noisy because the walls were constructed like this. You can hear easily what another person in another room is doing. And it's very inconvenient when you want to sleep or you want some privacy, you know. So this thick carpet on the wall makes people more happy because they didn't hear any noise anymore. And another thing, it is, of course, heating. It was more warm in this house with this thick carpet on the wall. And another thing very popular in Soviet Union was this curtain, like this. There was no door, only curtain. And this colorful cover on the armchair or on the sofa is also very typical Soviet thing. And this ugly, I would say ugly, I'm sorry, but I do think it's ugly, furniture. It was dark and very hard to move, you know. If you put the cupboard here, it will stay here forever because you cannot move it anymore. It's very heavy thing and not beautiful, I do think so. Okay. So now we will talk about Russian words. Двери. Двери means door. Кухня. Кухня. Kitchen. Кухня. Микроволновка. Микроволновка. Microwave oven. Шкаф. Шкаф. Cupboard. Actually, шкаф you can use for any type of cupboard, even for wardrobe where you store your clothes, even for bookcase. For all of this, you can say шкаф. And холодильник. Холодильник, fridge. If you learn Russian language, most probably you know this word холодно, cold, холодно. So холодильник and холодно, they have the same root, cold. And посуда, посуда, dishes. Крыша. Крыша. I always show like this. Крыша. Чердак. Чердак. Attic. Здание. Здание. Please don't mix this word with задание. Задание. exercise. Здание, building. Remember this, please. It's very important. And all my Russian learners, they mix these two words. Небоскреб. Небоскреб. Here are two words connected. The first is небо, sky, and скреб. We have this verb скрипсти. It's what cat makes when she wants to go outside, like. So it means that небоскреб, it scrapes the sky with his, it scrapes the sky with his roof like this. Yeah, небоскреб. Окно. Окно, window. And for curtains, we have two different words. You can choose any you like. So, занавески, занавески, or you can say шторы, шторы. I think that шторы is somehow very similar to French or English. I think you have some similar word. Занавески, шторы. Now let's move on to bathroom. Shower, душ, душ. Ванна, ванна, ванна. Here is important thing, don't mix, please. Ванна is a bathtub where you can lay, right? And ванная is bathroom. Труба. Труба. Деревянный дом. Деревянный дом. I love wooden houses. Крыльцо. Крыльцо. I think it's very interesting concept because I couldn't find the good word to translate it in English. So I just made like this. Крыльцо, it's a little stair and some little space before, in front of the door. Yeah, крыльцо. And you must be super careful in winter because when you go outside the house, on the крыльцо, you can easily fall because there is some ice and snow and it's very slippery there.
Телевизор. Телевизор. Тумбочка. Тумбочка. Стул. Стул. Балкон. Балкон.
And this is what I was talking about, bath and bathroom. So bathroom, ванная. And bath, where you can lay and, I don't know, it is called ванна.
Зеркала. Зеркала.
Mirror.
Раковина. Раковина.
Sink. Кран. Tape. Кран. No, you say tap.
Лестница. Лестница. Картина. 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 Кровать. 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 Подушка. Подушка. Одеяло. Одеяло.
Blanket.
Лифт. Лифт.
Yeah, elevator.
Этаж. Этаж.
Floor. Here you should be very careful because in Russian the ground floor is not zero. It is not second. I don't know, in different countries around the world you have different enumeration. In Russia, the ground floor is the first floor. That's it.
Полка.
Полка.
Плита. Плита.
Still in Russia, we have two different types of ovens. First one is electrical, and the second one is with gas. In old buildings, we have only gas.
Потолок.
Потолок.
Гостиная.
Гостиная. It is connected with the word гость, which can be translated as guest. Because in living room, normally, if you have a party or a business meeting or something like that, you appoint it in living room, where you can have lots of guests, right? Гостиная. Or you can use another word, зал. Зал. Диван. Диван. Sofa.
Спальня.
Спальня. Bedroom. It is connected with the word спать. Спать, to sleep. Спальня, the same root, спа. Сп. Yeah? So, спальня is the place where we sleep. Где мы спим.
Лампа.
Лампа. Кабер. Кабер. And now I have to say that now in Russia almost nobody puts the carpet on the wall. It stayed in Soviet era.
Стена.
Стена. Wall. Yeah. Стол. Стол. Table. Пол. Пол. Floor.
Камин.
Камин. Свечи. Свечи. I have lots of students in Europe and in USA, and they always tell me that candles are quite popular in those countries because they try to waste less money on electricity and different facilities, and candles help them to do this. But in Russia, candles are not popular at all. Свечи, not popular.
And also, I wanted to show you a Russian stove.
So here it is, Russian stove. We call it русская печка, and it has many important functions. First of all, of course, to heat the whole house. We have a stove at my dacha house, but it is not as big as this one. So the first function is to heat the house. The second function is to cook or to warm your food. You can do it here. Yeah. And another function is heating bed. It's super nice feeling. You have this bed and you can sleep there and you feel yourself so warm, and it's very pleasant feeling. Yes. So three important functions. And now, of course, winters are not as cold and severe as it was many years and many centuries ago. So yes, now Russian people normally do not do this heating bed, but many years ago
In every Russian hut, in every Russian house, there was a Russian stove like this. So, my dear Russian learners, I hope that this Russian lesson was useful for you, that you knew some interesting and new information from my YouTube channel. And if so, please subscribe to my channel if you are new, and hit the like button, leave me any comment, and if you have any other question related to Russia, Russian culture, Russian language, please answer me anything, and I will definitely answer. See you soon. Увидимся скоро. Пока-пока. Bye-bye.